Hello everyone, hello, welcome to our thrill studio. Welcome Jyoti, hello everyone, hi Rupa, Geeta. Okay, can you hear me and see me? Please type a yes if it is visible and the audio is clear. Then we will start with today's session. So waiting for a yes, just write a yes if you can view and hear it well. Oh, hi Anushree. Good afternoon. Okay, thank you Sahej. I got the first yes from Sahej. Okay everyone, today we are going to start with our next painting in Kalamkari, and I'm as thrilled you are, I'm also thrilled that really we are creating good paintings, and I can see so many people really excited and enthusiastic to learn this new art form. Though we have covered quite a bit, today we are going to do a different painting on Krishna. So we are going to make the full painting of Krishna. Probably the sketching part and the coloring will come later as a video. And since Janmashtami is around the corner on Monday, you can create a Krishna painting. I have noted down many requests on Shiva and Durga, which we will be doing later. But just right now, we will start with this. Thank you, Geeta. Thank you. Okay, so I will focus it on the table and I will tell you how we are going to start, what stuff you need, though it's not very different. I have taken a cartridge paper. So if you want a drawing sheet, just take a little thick 170-200 GSM or above will be good. 300 GSM, perfect. Right? And for drawing, I often use pencil to chalk my design first. So just to give it a little sketch where it is going to come. So you can make use of a pencil. Any pen you may use, but it has to be a waterproof pen. Because later when you paint it, the colors will not mix with the black outline. So any pen which is a waterproof pen, though there are many pens which say that they are waterproof, it is written that it is waterproof, but they are just water resistant. So I would say that if you are using a gel pen in black, like this I have from Link, but when the paint and the water comes in contact with it, it gives some pigment. So please check it in the rough and then only start if you are trying with a new pen. Because few of them do say it is waterproof. It says it is waterproof, but actually it's not very very water resistant. So the Uniball Eye waterproof pen and a fade proof pen. So always take a very good pen, because you are putting in a lot of efforts and you are putting in your time in it. So you don't want something to happen with a beautiful creation that you have made. So any pen which has a good black ink. So waterproof is good, and always check for a fade proof also, because over the time, like few years, you would see that the black would fade off. You don't want that to happen. So take a fade proof. So here I will be using the Uniball Eye, but to first start with the Krishna. Okay, there was a video that we created last class and I got so much of love from you all. And this was the Ganesha that we created, and I made it into a monochromic painting. The video of it will be uploaded. And here it is only one color that has been used throughout. So not all the paintings in Kalamkari are very, very colorful. They can be monochrome. So monochrome is just use of one color and the shades of that, light and dark of one or two shades. So here white is the paper and I have used this color. So giving it a very subtle and a rustic look, I have created this. So this is a monochromic. We will do different kinds of variations in how to do shades and all in many upcoming videos. Is it not okay? Is it not possible to draw using pencil once the painting is done? We can redraw using pen. Yes, you may draw with pencil right away if you're not very confident that you may just go wrong on it. You can draw the full picture with pencil and then you may try to redo it with the pen. That is also okay. Now, here to start with, I'm going to make a Krishna. And first, how to see how big paper you are taking. So, I'll just raise up the camera here. So, give the idea of the paper and the proportions, because the proportions are very important when you start a new picture. Otherwise, your torso, your upper half of the body, the lower part of the body, the head, and things will go a little wrong. So, when we make any gods and goddess, we just have to take a little lower, because considering that they will always have a mukut or whatever the head, whatever they're wearing on the head. So, here I will be taking one section here, two here. So, whatever your paper is, I'm dividing into roughly eight parts. One, two, three. Okay, how would you divide eight parts if it is an even number? Best part is divide it into half. Okay, so here you divide it into half. Thereafter, you divide it into half. So you got four. Then you divide it into further halves. So this is a way you can get onto the equal proportions. So now I have eight equal proportions. So sometimes it will happen if you don't have a scale or if you have to judge by the eye. The best part for the even ones is plot the center, then further plot the centers, and then make the centers go again. So this is how the main just the thing is. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Please feel yourself very welcome, though I'm not able to address everybody, but you're all a part and very cooperative. So all are welcome. No, it's not a printing paper, it's a little thick paper. The printing papers are really thin papers. So this is a paper which is 170 or I think 200. I got it loose papers. I think 200 GSM would be there. Okay, so now from here I will be starting the Krishna picture, and the Krishna picture is we have seen many pictures with him with the cow, since that's the shepherd look that he was in. Today we are going to do the mandap. So I will be taking the center of the page. So always make a rough line in the center so that your figure is not shifted from the center. Like this. And here I will be drawing this is the first portion where I will be drawing the mukut. So very roughly I'm making that. I will lower the cameras for a proper viewing. Here, very little. So it's like a conical shape here. Here is the face. The face will come over here in this. Now this is the body, the upper body. The next part is the upper body. The next part is the lower body. Then comes the legs. So we will start from this, and now I will make one hand over here on top, the other hand like this, the hand which we made it for, or we make this kind of a hand for all the gods and goddesses. That is the mudra, that is like a blessing. So the hand is all front facing like that. So we are just making a simple figure with two hands and not many limbs. We see majorly in the two gods that we see many limbs are there. First is the Nataraj form of Shiva, where he is dancing, you will see many limbs, and the Durga form of the goddess. So you will have limbs. So here to start with, again the face, a circle. I'm done with the line, just plotting it. I'm taking my uniball pen. You may use a uniball pen as well. Gel pen also, Rishad. So here, as we know, we just make the circular face. I will just put it down so that it's okay. I hope this is clear. Now here, I am making, I'm assuming this as a face. I'm making the kundal, the place for the kundal. And first we make kundal because sometimes the face is kind of hidden. The cheek part is hidden behind. Like this, the side where the crown is. Now giving it the curve of the head. Multi lines. You have to see that they both are falling in the same line. This is the second band of the mukut. The mukut can be as elaborate as you want, as much high you want, but roughly, if you are making gods, how long, how big it has to be. If you are taking the face, whatever the measurement is the face, you can take the double of it. If in case we are making normal humans, like when we make the full panel of gods and goddesses, it is like not only one figure, there are attendants or the sabha or rishi, muni, where we do not make the head accessories so high, then it will just be the half of it. So the hair plus a turban or anything would come, or a smaller jewelry part will just make it look beautiful. So if it is not a crown, if it is a crown, it doubles the thing. If it is not, you can just add half of it. So here I'm adding the more mukut. Since I have already plotted my center, I am taking the center and making this tikka. Left and right, I will be making the eyes. I simultaneously do my work on the left and right so that it always follows a balance. Giving a little thickness over here. Now we will be doing the eyes. Fish shape eyes. So this is a fish shape eye. You will see that the corners are also cut. Now when we make the face, the eye is a part that cuts the face into two equal parts. So we will follow the same. this line for the eyelids and then the nose. I will curve the side of the face, and there also a very nice curve. So this is the face here. The portion here will have the ear. And we can make the design a little more detailed. I will go ahead and make the complete this portion. Should I make bun? Yes, Rishit, you can make bun. In fact, when we make Krishna in a Balroop means as an infant or a child, we do not put such a big head, mukut, we won't put. So we will see a different, when we make him as a shepherd or not as an idol, then it will be having a different form of. So in this, particularly this god, when we see Krishna, we see all stages of Krishna. And from those a very infant where he's on a very minimalistic kind of thing, bare body, all chubby, we make that to a very manly, like when we make the Kalamkari pictures where he is telling Arjun about Gita, then that is another roop. So this god has different forms and different expression and different body structures as well. You will see manly, very poised, sometimes very naughty, different movements will be there, standing, dancing. So all those mudras, you will see versatile drawing in this. You may also do a little detailing on the I'm giving the side design as well. Like this. It's very beautiful mukut shape. I'm placing a kamal, a lotus over here. You may or may not do this design. The designs can be different. Thank you, Mehak. Thank you so much. Fill in with the beads. And this finishes my face part. Now giving it a little more hanging onto this side. This earrings or karnaphool, whatever you call it. Now with this I will go to the neck. This is a fold of the neck, and here comes the necklace. Generally, when we see gods, we see that this portion, even if it is a motif, if it is a motif of a god and we do not want to do anything, we want to do it on a fabric or maybe a dress material as on kurta or anything, then only this could be a good piece to be done. You can use a nib also when you are doing it on the fabric, but using fabric paints. Dilute the fabric paints and you can do the outline. And later if you want, there are many people who ask me what What do we use for fabric? Can we do this on fabric? Fabric colors. Acrylic paint is a wide range. We get a lot of acrylic paints. Depends on the polymers. And now with these acrylic paints can be done, normal acrylic paints and tubes can be done on paper, on canvas and other things. It is a very versatile medium. But there is one acrylic paint that comes from for fabric specifically. Reason being, the binder is more and it sticks to the fabric. It sticks to the fabric and the fabric will not be very tight. So otherwise the painted area is very stiff. So that is. Okay. Now here. Now this is one limb I have put it here. And as we did the Ganesha also, I mentioned this. Once you want to make the figure, there are overlapping limbs also. So it is better to get the form straight. So from here, I will make the front of the body. This is the upper part of the body. And now I will be making the next part as the hand going up. And the other side. I've made the limbs roughly, very roughly. See to it that both the limbs are of the same size. It shouldn't go thick, or one is thick and the other is thin. So just go on to that part. Now that is done. Later you have to anyway erase the lines. So going on to this limb first, because it is covering the chest, and if you happen to make the chest first, the line will show up. So like this, gods and goddesses will be wearing a lot of jewelry, and we will continue making that. First I'll draw, and then probably we can. Give the detailing of the jewelry, and thereafter we just have to connect a little so this hand comes straight. This is the part of the body, the upper body. And now the jewelry part. And now the center piece. When you do start from the corners, you will get the center. And the center can be a little more elaborate, because generally we get the pendants or the extended design in the middle. This, excuse me. Now, creating another another long necklace. I'm creating a little different design for the outer. This. We'll go ahead and complete all the detailings on the upper body. The same design what you have done for one hand, you will be repeating it for the other. And here so here this will come like now this hand is up, but then he will be holding. Now this form of Krishna is the one which is dancing on the snake. So Kalia the head, it is from the Kalia the head, where the snake is Kalia and the whole place was infested by the demon, and then he took over. What would be the next session after Kalamkari? I hope you are following me on my Facebook page. If you are, you will be getting all the notifications from there. Now we'll move to this, the lower part. Now for the lower part, there is one very different kind of a feature that comes is this. This is the center. And this gets to be the curve of the body. So this is a feature that you will see for the center part of the body where the navel is placed over here in such kind of pictures. So here, so it's just very similar, just make three curves and then you connect it.
so.
Now this is, now when there are many pictures where you will see that when we are making the dashavatar or any other thing, I'm just giving you a concept here, when there is a fish, matsya avatar, from here only the fish will start. When it is a tortoise, then the here is the tortoise form. So whatever form the god is in, you can just continue the lower. If the lower has to change, it will change from here. If in case the whole body has to be the same and the face has to change, just like Narsimha, only the face, but the some portions will be very familiar, as in only few portions will be from the form and the other will be human. So like this. Now I'll give you a rough sketch of how to do the leg part. Since in the bottom over here, I'll just raise it a little. Here. So this is already done. And now we have covered one section is here, second section is here, third, fourth, fifth. So five sections are over. So first is a space we have left. Then second is the headgear. Third is the face. Fourth is the upper part of the body. And the fifth is the lower part till the navel. Now, they will have a vastra or the dress here. I will be doing this part here. You can do any design for this centerpiece. Now, it was a dancing form. So, how to make the folded legs? We have done this folded leg in the previous Ganesha also. What proportions should be there? So, take the torso and do the measurement like this. What you will do is, when extended, the center portion, this block, gets added up. So here, and this is the fold of the leg. So this is one side of the fold of the leg. The other side is the dancing form, and it goes a little because it is in a standing formation. See to it that both are having the same thickness, but it will kind of flow. It will flow because the dress is such that it will give you the hang of the dress will actually add up to the skin. Here it is bare and the body form is visible. Here it is not bare and we won't be able to see the body form. So this. Here we will draw the foot. Like this, and since this foot is placed on the nag, then we will just make a curve like this. This is the place where the head will be. This is the center. This is the side. So it's just like a big petal that we are making. Whereas this is the center. You will get a proper shape when we will do it with a pen directly. So this is a form. Now I will start doing it with a pen directly. Yeah. So first we will be giving the outline. I just took a rough reference here, but I'm not tracing the lines. Now, I will elaborately do the waist. Decoration part or the jewelry part is just up to you. How much ever you want to add, you may add. But we, while we are doing in the manner of like, okay, if you want to speed up and you eliminate this, it will affect the picture a lot. Thank you, Neha. Thank you so much. Yeah. Adding those U design, looks like Diwali design, Diwali lights. So we'll continue doing that. Now the center cloth. You may add a border, print, anything, frills, whatever your wish is. Like we put different kinds of accessories to our gods, we would be doing the same over here. You can go and be creative and keep on doing the variations. I'm just doing a straight partition with such design. This looks very beautiful, especially when you take alternate colors. It looks very good. So, like this. For the dress also, I will be creating a border, and this kind of a curve looks very beautiful where the dress is folded. Thank you everyone. If you are liking the video, please press a like button so that I get to see it after when I'm done with my work. I get to see, okay, how many likes actually. So it boosts me up a lot. So if you're liking it, just hit a like button. And those who have not subscribed, I wish you subscribe and support the channel. Also, those who are liking this art and you want others to also be a part of it, share this workshop with others. And everybody is welcome in Art Thrill Studio group. Also, we have a WhatsApp group. If in case you want to connect me personally, you can just check in there as well. You can just write a comment, and then from there, if in case you want to connect, you may. You're most welcome. One more thing, yes, I would want to tell you that tomorrow maybe it's not possible for me to do the live class, but you will get a video for later because I have a power cut tomorrow. There's some maintenance issue that's going on and we won't be having any power at that time where the live is not possible. So that is one thing. So I'm so sorry about tomorrow. We won't be having a live session tomorrow, but yes, you will receive the video later. And here I am just doing these double rings to give it a little printed form. I will attach all the details in the chat box. Oh great, Indian art forms are very beautiful. And every state has a different art form, and I would say that Orissa is one very, very a state where we have lots and lots of art forms. It's beautiful. So this. Now I will continue with the down portion here, the leg. Do not miss on the detailing part. This is very beautiful and this will only enhance the picture. Only line drawing will not give the effects of color. Thank you so much for your subscription. Thank you. Here, like so, and then just add. If you are working with this, the best part of what I feel is working with the live is actually that you don't have to scroll up and down and you can actually work. So here, these are the two anklets and now I will be framing. With the adding of the jewelry, you will see that what had happened to me also, I will say, I just chopped it in pencil, but actually this is looking so beautiful and elaborate, I don't want to do it, so I will extend it anyway. Your ideas in pencil are very rough and you get the get to improvise it. So here I will just take and put a little bigger foot here, and the thumb gets a little flattened because it is placed down. So this is a side view of the foot and then the fingers, like this. I'm adding a nail as well. Here also, the heel, the depression, here, the thumb, and now I will be adding the slope of the foot and thereafter the fingers. In some, this is colored and we add a second outline also, which while you are coloring, you can add a pink or whatever color variation you want to give it to the back, to the lower side of the foot and the upper. So this is a variation. Especially, we do this for the ladies, mainly for the ladies. But yes, you cannot limit it to the ladies as well because so much of jewelry and everything. You can go ahead. Just adding the little frills on the dress. So this. here. Now I'm going with the sheshnag and just this curve here. First, I will take the center and do the main front facing head. I'll just lower it down. So it is just like a leaf, but a rounded tip over here. Sure, Surekha. I will be posting it very soon. I showed it in the beginning of the video of starting this that it has been colored. We will be posting it. Now here the side will be just like a leaf, rounded tip, and then the side. So it is like this. This will be inverted on the other side. The lower jaw, adding a little of the lower jaw, that's giving a little more beauty to this. And then while designing it, I will be adding few dots in here on the head so that while you are coloring, it stands out in a different . There is a variation. Now what are we going to do is I'm adding the body of the center one, which is like this. I'm adding the body of this one and this one. So it is a multi, it has five heads. So that is how it is coming. So it looks very intricate, but when you go step by step, it's not that difficult. Now for the sides of it, because it was just curling on the in the water while the snake was even the snake was being taken by the god, so we'll do the water first. So now this portion will be inside the water, as in not the god, it is just showing the background, and we'll just give it a little wavy thing as the water. Waters here, and then some body of the. Now I'm adding the body, because now once you have placed the foot and everything, now it gets easier for you to locate how much of the body is going behind the foot. So that is why when we are doing the layering, it is important for us to figure out that. Now here, I will just take the tail over here. Here, giving it a beautiful curl. And like that, it's a little twist. It's very rough. We'll be doing it with the pen directly now. Like this. So this is it. Now quickly we'll just shape up the body. When we see the body of a it goes just by the observation. The lower part of the snake is a little different from the upper part. So we'll just create that, and we'll do it for all of them. So here I'm creating that ribbed effect which is there on the lower part of the snake's body. Like this, and this again, those kind of, this is a very elaborate picture, and the background also takes a lot of time. Whereas if in case it's only the idol, it will finish up very quickly. We will repeat the same for all. Like this. Now the whole body of the snake will follow the same design. Now this is also having the same design. The coloring of this picture might, this we will do in colorful, this we will do colorful, and the that will come as a video later. So today I will upload for the Ganesha, which we have already done. I showed it in the beginning, I'll show it in the end as well, how we do it in the monochromic way. And this we will do a bit of shading in here. Now, this part I have made very rough. I'll give it a little more twist here. Like this. Now continue, because it's a twisted body here, we'll continue this line not facing inside, it is twirled the other side as well. This is how this whole picture is turning out to be. We will add the same design, the same repetition you can add there. Now going to the waters. The waters are also very, very important here, because there is one pattern that goes with water. So we're just doing the double outline here, dividing the background with this. If you want to add the trees here, how would you add the different forms? It totally depends, because this will not have a mandap, because it is having waters and it is an outdoor scene. If you want to create this with a mandap, you may. But if in case you want to do it like this, you can add clouds here and the tree. Here I will be telling you the background part, I will leave it, and I will be telling you how to do what is. So there is a very important way of doing this water with, but a very specific kind of waters. We do not do waves in it. We do dots for water bubbles probably, and the double lines. This can be closer or far, like this. That is how water is shown. Fill up the whole thing like this. It can follow a little wave. You may add fishes and fish and other turtles, tortoise, whatever you want to add, you can add it in the background. I will keep it full with water. This is one way we do water in Kalamkari. And only the white bubbles will be left, rest all you can color it. I'll add the water over here as well. So this is how the whole thing will come out to be. We'll just take 2 more minutes to finish this portion, and then it will. I will just forward this as a video where it all will be covered, and you will get a tutorial on that. A little bit of the background, as per your desire, whether you wanted to leave it just like few gods. Generally, this happened, and the small on the clouds. There were beautiful god figures who were pushing, who were offering. Flowers to the god. That can happen, anything. It depends on how beautifully you want to illustrate the picture. So the background, I'll leave it to you, or if in case you want to follow me, you follow the background as in the next tutorial. Now these portions also you may add the water, these. So this is the picture that is almost ready. Here also the same thing will follow on. I hope you like the picture. If you have any other suggestion, any other god figure or any other form of Kalamkari that you want me to do and teach, you can write it to me on my Facebook page or in the comments below. And I will consider it and clear all your doubts or queries or requests. Your requests are very dear to me. If you have any suggestions, do write it in Kalamkari. Like if in case in Kalamkari, because ongoing is Kalamkari. If you have anything in Kalamkari that you want to learn, please write it before we close this workshop and we start with the next one. For updates, I wish that you follow my Facebook page as well, because we might share all our plans and requests and on the Facebook page. You don't have to be very calculative while you are doing it, because this is a form of a freehand design done with the kalam. Now we are just recreating that legendary way of doing it on the cloth, washing and dyeing and all the process. We are just using the pens and doing it on the paper. So don't feel that it is being misguided that you have to do it on the paper. Initially it started with only doing it on the fabric. Now it is just with our convenience and that we are doing here and creating the pictures in paper and pen. So this is a beautiful picture wherein you have the background very full, and once you color it, it will stand out amazingly. So only the background, you can go elaborate and do the full of it. You may leave it. I suggest you do few, the trees, whatever comes to your wish, you can do it in this Krishna Ashtami picture. This is the most celebrated form of Krishna. We will try and do the infant Krishna as well. If you have any queries, you please write it down and I'm available to answer all of them right now. Before that, I would be showing you one the picture that we did in the previous class. It's painted and now how it is looking. So this is a form of the picture that came up, and I did it in monochromic way. So those who have not seen it at the beginning of this, so this is, the video will be uploaded very soon, and the same we will do for our Krishna. So all the pencil lines that you have right now, you can just erase them off, and this is a beautiful Kalamkari picture that will be ready in just 1 hour's time. Little more, you will be able to paint it as well. If you like it, press a bell icon also if you want notifications on what we do and whenever we upload a new video, as well as plan the new sessions. Very good, Rishabh. Nice. Share with us. Okay, so any queries, anything, please write it down and I'll answer. Okay, thanks for liking the videos and be a part of it. Tomorrow we might not be able to take the live session I'm saying, but yes, the videos will be uploaded later and you can always have a look at it and follow. The patches appear. Yes, the patches, I in my video on, I think there is a Kalamkari video where we were doing the painting, I mentioned, if in case the patches are coming, probably you are not taking a same thickness of the paint. So dilute the paint and make it ready for the size that you need. And the second thing is, when you paint it, the paint is still wet, try to rub it off once you see the pileups. When the pileup dries, the color gets darker. And when wherever it is dragged more, it will be lighter. Okay, thank you everyone. I will see you next time. Bye. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being a part of it. I love you all.